Guys, AI is replacing jobs left and right, but it's not just Silicon Valley that's impacted. In today's video, I'm gonna explain exactly how auto mechanics and auto service shops are using AI to replace humans and scale up profits. I'm gonna give you some specific real world examples. And guys, this is not just theory, this is not just what's coming, this is what's happening right now. I was talking to a friend of mine who is the manager for a large region of auto mechanic chains. And what he's doing with AI, what this company is doing with AI, is really unprecedented. It was really shocking to me how the numbers actually line up. So again, smash subscribe, smash the like button. I'm gonna get right into it and stick around to the end because I think you're gonna be surprised with the exact implications. It's pretty shocking. So, okay, let's get into it. So the first thing that these guys are using in their auto mechanic shop, and again, just to be clear, if you have a problem with your car, you need to get it serviced, you know, the oil, change oil lights on, whatever, you bring it into auto mechanic shop, what happens next? Well, they bring it up on the line and one of their techs is going to grab his tablet, which is AI driven, of course, everything's AI. He's got his tablet, he's got some smart glasses and he's gonna walk around your car and he's gonna look at all the different lights that are on, he's gonna check the gauges, he's gonna open the hood. And while he's doing this, he's actually speaking. And these smart glasses are listening to what he says, inputting all the video from the video, inputting photos, recording his voice, all inputting all this information. After he's done with his walk around, he hits a button and it sends all of that information over to another computer in their office. Now, what's interesting about this computer is it is unmanned. No human is ever touching this computer. It is all driven by an AI agent. And what this AI agent does is it puts the entire proposal together. It sources parts, it gets parts from suppliers, it gets price from suppliers, it confirms the availability, it checks OEM versus aftermarket options, it calculates the leather, the labor, how much the service is gonna cost, taxes, all of that. It calculates all that, puts it together in a nice, clean proposal, and then prepares it to send to the customer. Now, what's interesting in this case is he can actually send the proposal automatically using the AI. The AI can automatically send the message to the customer. The way that they have it set up is because a lot of these types of services are pretty expensive. They still like to have that human touch. They're actually calling the customer to say, hey, this is what we found, double check it. But here's where the numbers get interesting, because this process of putting the proposal together would typically take a tech, about 20 to 30 minutes to put together, compared to the computer, which does it in 6 minutes, but it's unmanned. You can be doing other things. You can be engaging with customers. You can be back on the line working. Regardless, the computer is handling all of it. Now, let's extrapolate that a bit, because his business is serving about 18 cars a day. They're serving about 18 cars a day. So if you're putting a proposal together of 18 cars, which takes on average 30 minutes, that saves his team 9 hours a day. That's an entire human being. That is saving each one of their shops $50,000 plus every year. And you know what? These systems, they don't get sick. They don't have a bad attitude. They just work. They just work. And he is absolutely crushing it with this AI proposal system. I thought it was super slick. I definitely want to tell you about it. But wait, there's more. It gets better. And guys, by the way, guys, all I do is talk about AI all day. People ask me, Mark, why are you doing this? Why are you doing these walk and talk videos? It's like all I talk about. Every time I'm at a party, I'm at an event, I'm always talking about AI because it's just so fascinating what's possible. And this gives me an outlet to talk about it so that I don't drive my wife crazy. At any rate, if you really want the back end, all the different stuff I'm looking at, you should subscribe to my newsletter. It's completely free. You're gonna get a backdoor stage pass to what I'm looking at, what's working, what's not working, what prompts I'm using, what's happening in the labor markets, how you can prepare. Guys, get the newsletter. It's completely free at AIUpdate.ai. AIUpdate.ai. And by the way, I love all the comments below. You guys are awesome. The email is one of the best ways to get into direct contact with me. If you plug into the newsletter, if you see something that you like, if you respond, that's a really good way to get in contact with me. So I appreciate it. AIUpdate.ai. All right, let's keep going, because this next example of how he's using AI is just so, so cool. So they're using an overnight AI answering service. And the service that he uses is called Call Connect. And it is so wild, guys. It is boosting the amount of appointments booked in their service shops by about 10 to 15% every single day. So how does it work? Well, 24/7, 365, this AI bot named Kate is answering calls. So it's especially effective after hours when people would typically call, they're upset, and they leave a message. Well, now they don't leave a message, they get on a phone call with Kate. Okay, now Kate is really good at her job. She sounds real, she uses human inflection, she pauses, she uses filler words like and you know to sound very, very natural. Kate also answers the call the same way every time. Kate is always happy. Kate doesn't get upset. Kate doesn't get frustrated. Kate, our AI bot in this case, answers calls at 100% efficiency and effectiveness 100% of the time. Kate doesn't go out drinking. Kate just does her job. And in her role, the way they have set it up, Kate's really number one function is to answer the call and get the person to book an appointment in the location the next day so that this person can get served by a tech. Okay, now what is interesting is Kate on average is booking two meetings every single night. Two meetings every single night, guys. I was shocked that it was working out that well. And the friend of mine, he actually played me a replay of someone who was actually talking, because you could hear the replays of all the calls that Kate has. And you know what? This guy had no idea that he was talking to an AI bot. All he wanted was to resolve a problem that he had, and Kate was there to solve it. He even said, oh, I see that your office is closed because I'm on Google and it says closed, but he still called anyway. And what would have happened if Kate wasn't there to answer? You know what would have happened. He would have called, he would have left a message, bad experience for him. The appointment would not have been booked. The techs would come into the body shop the next day. Maybe they see and answer and follow up the call. Maybe they don't, who knows? Maybe they were out drinking the night before and they're a little hungover. Maybe they're in a bad mood. Not Kate, guys. Kate is on it. And he's been incredibly, incredibly pleased with this system, and so have his customers. And again, we take this number of, they're taking about 18 vehicles per day. This thing is booking two calls per night. Guys, it is scheduling about 10 to 15% of their appointments on their location, which is absolutely bananas. I don't think people understand exactly what's happening in the industry right now. So that's pretty cool. Another thing that he said he's using, which I thought was really interesting, and this is something that I'm glad you stuck around because I think this is really cool. So my friend William is managing several locations, like an entire region that he's responsible for. And one of the things that he will do is, or that one of his job functions is making sure that underperforming shops have plans to grow and to get back in shape and start improving efficiencies, et cetera, et cetera. So what he will do is he will download a spreadsheet of all the different shops, all their KPIs. He will then upload all those charts, data points, KPIs to ChatGPT, and then ask ChatGPT, hey, look at store 512, what could they do better? Where there is opportunity? Why are they falling short? What are the implications? What can we do to improve the performance? Questions like that. And he said that the responses he's getting back from ChatGPT are absolutely perfect and profound. And here's the best part. If you've ever been a manager of people, you understand that a lot of times, you know, there's some, you know, like kind of like politics that happen between people, not politics like Republican versus Democrat, but politics meaning like, you're the new guy, I don't want to listen to you, or Sam's my boss, or who do I really report to, that kind of thing, right? Well, or say like, oh, you don't know what you're doing, I've been doing this for 30 years, I'm the man, I know what I'm doing, you don't know what the hell you're talking about, all that kind of stuff, right? So what's interesting about this that he said was, well, when I speak to the shop that's underperforming, I don't have to go in and say, this is my opinion. I can say, hey, this is what AI is recommending we do. What do you think? So what he's actually doing is using AI as a neutral third party arbitrator to make suggestions and to give feedback. And he just thought that was really profound. The last point I want to make here on this, so again, by the way, whether you're in the auto business or not, you can still, and I talk about this a lot, upload your charts, upload your graphs, let AI give you assessments and summaries and look at your KPIs. It's very, very powerful. Make sure that you are not uploading sensitive personal information or data that's proprietary. That's something you need to be aware of, because anything you upload into an AI LLM could potentially go public. We don't know exactly where all this stuff is going. So just take that little disclaimer there. And then lastly, the other thing that he had mentioned to me, what that he found was interesting, and I actually covered this in a video a little while ago, is that consumers are now far, far more educated than they were in the past. And I recorded an entire video on how this is impacting the medical field. I'll put a link to it here. I think it's really interesting, because what he found is that when people are coming in with problems with their vehicles, they are much more well-informed. They speak the language. They can figure out OEM versus aftermarket. They can figure out labor costs. They can kind of, you know, and what that means is that if you don't know what you're doing as a mechanic, or as, you know, whatever your profession, but in this case, if you don't know what you're doing as a mechanic, you know, customers are gonna be able to sniff that out. They're gonna be able to smell the BS. And what he found was that when you say something that's legitimate, and the customers are saying, oh, okay, cool, that's what ChatGPT said, it sounds like you know what you're doing, we'll run with that. So I thought that was an interesting, that's not necessarily directly impacting his business, but I thought it was a really interesting dynamic that's playing out. And again, we saw that play out in the medical field as well. Guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I really want to enlighten you on what's happening with AI, with the labor force. This is the time to innovate, boys. This is the time to think differently, because the world has completely changed. And if you like today's video, I know you're going to love yesterday's video. We're going to go through the new AI Meta smart glasses and what's possible with them. What are the new business opportunities that are opening up? We even looked at it today, using smart glasses to look at a vehicle and diagnose problems on a vehicle. There's so many cool things you can do with these AI smart glasses. We covered it all in yesterday's video. Check it out here, and I'll see you there, boys. All right, see ya. Peace.